Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this short video, we will see how we can test optocoupler using multimeter. I will use 1.5 volt battery cell and a multimeter to test this optocoupler. If we check, it is PC817. Here we have a cut mark. That is index pin. That is guide pin. This is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. The similar here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pin 1, that is anode, pin 2, that is cathode. Here we have LED and here we have transistor. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 and 4. 3 number pin is emitter, 4 number is collector. Let's test it. I will install on this project board so we can hook up the pins very easily. This pin is emitter. And I will connect a red jumper to pin number 4, that is collector pin. Collector to red wire. Emitter to black wire. Pin number 3, common wire. I will turn on to set to ohms. It must be open. It is a good condition. I will use black lead to connect to pin number 2 and red lead at anode. For safety purpose, we can use 100 ohm resistor. We can connect at pin number 1 to apply positive voltage as a current limit resistor. If you don't have, we can use without resistor, it's safe. For safety purpose, I will use resistor here. Now I will connect pin number 2 to the battery negative terminal and pin number 1 through 100 ohm resistor to the battery positive terminal. It is 1.5 volt battery. The output side transistor, it will measure 1.5 kilo ohm. Okay, if I will connect without resistor at that time, it's around 100 ohms. So this one is good. Now let's check another one. This one is good. Now I will check this one. I'm not using a resistor. It is for safety. If you have a new battery cell, at that time you can use the resistor to protect the LED. Otherwise, if we use 1.5 volt, it is safe. This optocoupler is not responding. This optocoupler have no response. Okay, we can check another one. This one, no response. We can check another one. Yes, that's good. 100 ohm resistance is when we connect without resistance. If you will connect with resistance, at that time it will work in transfer ratio. It is 1.5 kilohertz. 100 ohm resistor at pin number 1 and the positive, and our multimeter is reading 1.4k. Okay, if we have two multimeters, let me connect two multimeters here. If we have two multimeters, at that time no need to connect this one side, just only connect black lead, common lead, to pin number 3, red lead to pin number 4, this multimeter in resistance mode and this one in diode mode. Connect red lead to pin number 1 and black lead to pin number 2. Now this will show the voltage of the LED side. Now it is showing the LED voltage and it is showing the collector resistance, emitter to collector resistance. Now let's change the optocoupler here. This one is good, and now we'll connect this one. You can see this one is good. And now if I will check this one, input LED is short circuit. We can see It is just only 52 ohm resistance. It is short circuit. So when LED is short circuit, it will not give any resistance, it will not bias the transistor. So this optocoupler is bad. If we have two multimeters at that time, we can use two multimeters for testing, one in LED, one in resistance mode. It is a quick test. This must be in LED mode. If you will use in resistance mode, at that time, this will not show anything. We need to energize LED. Then the output transistor will work. LED, here we have resistance 1.41K. It is 20K resistance range. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.